we have talked a little bit earlier about different ways of protect ourselves. I guess that's one of the very important and interesting topics that audience would like to know as well. What are the ways that as an individual that we can protect ourselves from the cyber attacks and threats? Yeah, so you have just mentioned something about the mobile protection, the Wi-Fi protection. What else?
So we're all familiar with email. In fact, I get so many email, I can't even read it anymore, right, at work. So private and corporate emails are really under attack. There's an estimated 3,000% increase with COVID-19. Because what'll happen now, you know, in your Gmail, there'll be something come in, click here for the latest Singapore COVID status. And the domain looks a little bit like, you know, something.edu.sg.
Yes.
You just click it.
Yes. And it's Hot Topics.
It's Hot Topics. And it will actually take you to a phishing website, but actually show you the Singapore website. It looks real, but the hackers have already got you. They've already run some type of executable. They're already owning your machine. So email, you've got to be very careful.
Email.
Okay. Your corporate email, even though you're protected by, your company definitely has security products.
Yes.
Don't click on a link if you don't know it. There's actually something big. This one is, there's a term for it. Basically, when you send money back and forth, you know, you transfer money for goods or services. So hackers are not going over after small accounts. They're looking for big payoffs. So what they'll do, they'll do a phishing campaign. They'll get login credentials to a domain. And then they'll create a new user in exchange. And then it'll be an administrative user. They can actually read people's emails. So they read what the VP is saying. They read what the finance department is saying. And they just watch. They just sit there for a couple months. They learn.
Wow.
And all of a sudden, they see that there's some transaction coming up. Finance, the VP will say, please send the routing number to this one. We're just changing. And the VP says, oh, fine. I do this all the time. Click. Millions of dollars gone.
Wow.
This is huge and this happens all the time.
So that's not reversible damage.
It's not reversible. You can't get that money back. Once somebody sends money somewhere, then it gets moved around, just like in the movies, you never get it back.
Wow. So that really happens.
That happens all the time. In fact, that's one of the first slides in every security vendors. They always show that.
Okay. Yeah. So email, you really have to be careful about the emails.
You must be careful about the emails.
Yeah.
The next, so we talked about a little bit about the mobiles, SMS. Everybody gets a lot of emails. Here in Singapore, you get like racing track emails, and do you want to sell your flat type emails, all these type of things. If there's a link, never click it. No. The average person is not sending you a link in SMS. Maybe in WhatsApp, they chat with you. Those SMSs are branded phishing campaigns, waiting to capture people. Wow. Absolutely.
Wow.
Now the messaging apps, I mean, you got the big one, you got your WhatsApps, you got your Telegrams, the same thing. You got to watch out for phishing. You got to watch out for links. Something happened. So who's the richest person in the world? Jeff Bezos. Nobody's hacking Jeff Bezos, right? He was hacked on WhatsApp. He was hacked on WhatsApp. He met some royalty over in the Middle East. They were exchanging videos of like a party and something. And the video that Jeff Bezos got on his phone was a malware. It took control of his phone.
Okay.
It's probably the reason Jeff Bezos got divorced, because all the because all those things were up. That's the backstory.
Okay.
That's what really happened.
Oh wow.
So if the richest person in the world can be hacked, we can be hacked too.
We can be hacked.
Yeah.
So James, we heard about the recent data breaches. And how does the dark web relate to all this recent news?
So the dark web, as I mentioned, it's kind of that dark area of the internet that's hard to get to. You need special software. These three articles, pretty recent. You know, you got 21% of Singapore businesses have been hacked. You've got thousands of files of MINDEF employees. You've got remote learning and education. The schools are locking things down.
Yep.
Cybersecurity news is everywhere here. So what are these hackers doing with the data, right? Do they just take the data and email it to somebody and sell it? No. They go to the dark web where all the other hackers are and they post their findings on an auction site. You've heard of eBay, right? So down on the dark web, they've got forums just like this. Yeah, they've got eBay auctions. And they'll, so say that you've got 10,000 credit records, you know, credit A from a certain bank. We'll start the bidding at $1 per record. Then somebody says, I'll pay $1.50. Somebody, I'll pay $3. Sold at $3, so $30,000 sold for that.
Wow.
Instant, it's gone.
So it's a very organized supply chain, very well organized system and ecosystem there.
It's extremely organized. In fact, we were just talking about this recently in one of the cybersecurity leadership councils. So say that a hacker is just getting started. You know, the bad guy, he's just getting started. He doesn't know what to do. He or she can go into the dark web, click on a forum, get some software. They don't have to write their own software. They can just get the software, maybe pay $100 for it. What if they can't use the software? You can pay monthly. You can get a monthly subscription on the dark web to be a hacker. They're very organized.
So organized.
Extremely organized. Scarily so.
Okay.
And you mentioned earlier about us coming together, the good guys, the countries.
Yep.
We need to get to the point where we are helping each other.
Yes, yes. Since they are so organized, the good guys need to be organized and united also to protect ourselves, to attack against those bad guys.
It's the only way we're going to prevent all these news articles from getting out of control. And it's the only way to protect our data and protect our lives.
Just a little bit of extension. Are the governments doing anything at the legal level? Are they coming together to, you know, form some kind of protection against the dark web?
They can't. So there's a lot of, the internet was set up to be a free and open zone. So if you take away the freedom of this website or of this portal, you break the whole system. So it's, there are discussions, of course, at the international level to try to reduce the effect, and they do go after the illegal activities, absolutely, but they can't just shut down the whole dark web because there's actually things in there that are not illegal. So very good question.
Yeah, I guess that's really the amazing part about the internet, about the cyberspace, because it's so free, it's everywhere, and it's boundaryless.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And you take away certain freedoms or certain capabilities, the whole model breaks. So.
Yeah.
Good question. It's definitely something I try to read about this. I read about the freedom of the internet, and it's an ongoing debate and ongoing legal discussions. It'll never end.
Okay.